10 years ago, John Armstrong met Anne, and it was an instant attraction. Joining forces in marriage and business, they set out to become multimillionaires. Together, they built UFIT, Coventry's third largest double glazing company. But like any organization, UFIT's continued success depends on the people working within it. And as Christmas approaches, the sales team's figures are not looking good.
Do you want me to depress you totally and get the call stats? And Dan was saying he's only had 11 people to call. And I know for a fact that one of the ones that Dan made outbound was to order his food. Because I met the man on the stairs. Lucas said he's only had 16 to call out of a database of 1,700. And Rebecca was saying that she's only had 14 to call out of a database of...
Oh, I don't know.
Now is the time for action. Now is the winter of our discontent. I tell you one thing I'm thinking of.
What?
Well, Napoleon's army, right? He had what he called his Imperial Guard. And they were like 5,000 of them. They had the best of everything. They were the best warriors. They never fought any battles, though. Until they're absolutely needed. But they said that each one of them was worth 5 normal troops. Well, that's what we need, an Imperial Guard. Yeah.
I'll place an advert right away.
Wanted. Must have served as an Imperial Guard in Napoleon's army, preferably. Although training will be given.
Bring home the uniform. Mm.
Something's going to happen, I'll tell you. Something's going to give. Something's brewing.
On his last visit, John and Anne's Zimbabwean business guru, Basil Meany, recommended the sacking of the entire UFIT sales force.
You guys haven't a clue. I can tell you that right now. They're dead. They just haven't fallen over. That's the only problem. Yeah. You can't have a company survive with that kind of attitude in there. I'll tell you something now, I'd fire the whole bloody lot.
What that Basil was saying was a load of bullshit. He's just chatting shit. Because I was fucking, I knew what he was going to say.
You're right.
John's hoping that a reality check from Basil will energise the sales team in the lead up to the busy Christmas period.
Forgive me, but from Africa we speak very straight. If you're not prepared to do what you're supposed to do, you don't deserve to be here. See, no company can ever go anywhere without the correct people making the sales. And if you're not making the sales, then you guys at fault. Totally. Totally. There is no excuse, there is no reason, there's nothing. You've got to look at yourself and say, what am I doing? You know, the other day I went to the second side of the room there and I was listening to guys making phone calls, and do you know what? In 40 minutes, one guy made a couple of calls. Nobody else made any calls. Nothing. Just never made a single call in 40 minutes. You got lists of names to phone. Oh, you were fiddling with a computer. Fiddling around here, fiddling around there. Somebody else, and then walking out, in and out the room, of course, with pieces of paper. That looked hanging impressive. But at the end of the day, the job wasn't really being done. Okay.
I couldn't do it on the computer.
Don't make excuses as to why you can't get on the phone. I don't know how you feel, but for me personally as an individual, I would actually be embarrassed. I'd actually feel a little bit like, hey, hold on here, man. You know, wait a minute, I've got this stuff and I really need to be doing something with it. Jeez. You guys are on a pig's back right now, and if I were you, I would be milking it for every cent I could. I tell you what, I would go mad right now.
Encapsulate and refine down. I know it's difficult, but I want to put 10 seconds worth of dynamite in there. So when anyone's ever feeling down, because you've done this good, I want them to be able to press the little button, get a shot up there, and then that mental picture to come back. If we speak really loud, clear, get that enthusiasm, let it flow like a river.
Guys, you are where you are because that's where you've chosen to be. Never, never, never give up.
Okay.
Right, let's have a play.
Come on, Basil, say it for me.
Guys, you are where you are because that's where you've chosen to be. Never, never, never give up.
Got the energy inside it. That's good.
Right, somebody's phoned up.
Yeah.
Somebody called Dave, asking if we've got any sales jobs going.
Mm-hmm.
What do you want me to do?
Get him in.
Okay.
Sometimes an individual can make the difference. Look at Julius Caesar. Hannibal, not Lecter, but Hannibal the commander. He made a difference, didn't he? Defeated the Romans, and he was an individual. Well, this bloke could be the same, and we've got to get him here to listen to him, see what he's got to say. See?
Okay.
You tell him it's an introductory interview. Okay, we want to find out a bit about you. We want to find out what kind of personality you are, what makes you tick.
Yeah, I'll phone him now.
Hello, is that Dave? Oh, sorry, someone's given me your number, but I think it's the wrong one, mate. Well, I'm so sorry about that.
Let's see if he wants a sales job.
No, he don't sound right. You know what I mean? Way answered the phone.
What do you mean he doesn't
it's
sound
just, right? No, didn't sound... Telephone manner weren't very good.
Was that him?
Yeah.
How can you possibly prejudge somebody like that? He only said hello.
No, it's the way he said it.
Unimpressed by John's recruitment technique, Anne's taking matters into her own hands.
Guys, you are where you are because that's where you've chosen to be. Never, never, never give up.
I interviewed some people and I've actually taken on somebody who Andy has already interviewed while I was away. And he had a few concerns. He sort of said there's something not right, you know, gut feeling and all that. And he tends to be one of these who goes with his gut feelings. We said, you talk to him and see what you think. Well, I just thought completely the opposite. I thought he's a young person, basically. He's about 19, 20 years old. But he's got 2 years' experience in this industry, but in a very hard sell way. Not in this namby-pamby, I'll phone you back in 3 years' time then. I don't want to bother you. I know while we were away, you interviewed that young lad, didn't you? And you said to come back for an interview with me. But you had reservations about him, didn't you?
Yes.
I invited him in on Tuesday and I had a really, really long chat with him.
Is this the lad with spiky hair?
Yeah.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Looks like Duran Duran region.
Yeah, he does actually. And I actually think he'd be very, very, very good. In fact, I think he'd be so good at giving him the job. I mean, we can get references and everything, but he has been used to running teams. Well, how about we have him as team leader? Because let's face it, the team that we've got are going to be mightily annoyed anyway when we introduce new people. So if we're going to have him as team leader, we might as well say he's team leader from day one. Interestingly enough, he used to work with Michael.
Don't trust him. Don't trust him. And I can throw him quite a distance, so... He's 19 years old and he knows everything about everything, and his humour's got a bit of a dark side, I think, and I don't really appreciate it. It rubs me up the wrong way sometimes. And that's about as much as I know about the guy.
Hey. Excellent.
Oh, it looks brilliant,
doesn't it?
It does, yeah. With the Christmas break just days away, John and Anne are planning to invite the staff for festive drinks at the soon-to-be-opened company bar.
Wicked shit,
rum and coke!
White wine for me!
There's a definite lead shortage right now. That's the way it seems to me. And they're looking to take someone else on. So... That says just one thing to me, and that means they're looking to get rid of people.
When they change something, if you don't like it, you know, just leave. So, we know the choices. Just we've got to make one.
On Monday, I came into work as usual, just expecting the last week to be quiet and totally uneventful. Dan, He turned round and handed me a piece of paper before I'd even opened my mouth and said, don't know whether this makes any difference. And I opened the piece of paper and it was his resignation. I sort of sat there stunned, really. But I said, obviously, we've got to now escort you from the premises. I said, it's nothing personal, it's just the way that we have to do things, and that was fine. Michael was sat at his desk, Luke was at his desk, and Rebecca was stood by Luke. And she got this piece of paper all folded up in her hands, sort of like this, rolled into a tube. And I went in and I said, oh, hello. And Luke said, Rebecca doesn't know how to tell you, but she wants to leave as well. Women's intuition, I don't know. I went to the sales office door, flung the door open, quite tongue-in-cheek, and said, right, before I go to the expense of reallocating these leads, are you two staying or are you going? And Michael said, well, I'm staying. Great, that's one. And Luke turned around and said, well, actually, I've got another job as well. They were like a house of cards, weren't they, John? Once one went, they all started. What did you liken them to this morning? Lemmings.
Guys, you are where you are because that's where you've chosen to be. Never, never, never give up.
I mean, stunned, yes. I mean, you're bound to be. You've just lost three quarters of your sales team. But you've got to look at every opportunity. And I'm just thinking now, what a great opportunity we've got. We have got the one person who is left. Is, let's face it, he's the one person who, since he's been here, we have never had to talk to about his timekeeping. Not once. Every time we look through that door at Michael, he's on the phone, isn't he, John?
Yeah,
he's on the phone. And he always is, every time we go in there.
So he's doing his job.
Yeah.
And he's getting results. So there's a fucking surprise.
With sole access to the hottest leads, Michael's results have improved significantly.
I was doing something right. Maybe I wasn't selling as spectacularly as Luke or Dan, but I'm here. They're not.
Supposedly got somebody starting. Ryan is starting in January. And he offered to be team leader. So hope he works well on his own.
Anne's called Ryan in to meet John and what's left of the UFIT sales team.
Looks like he should be a rock star. He looks like he's happy using the phone, so that's a good start. He's already streets ahead than three people we used to know. Quite a lot to tell you, a lot of excitement, a lot of changes already.
Already?
Yeah, you see, you leave me alone for a couple of days and it all changes. Right, come on in. Now, I'd like to introduce you to your sales team. Michael.
Is that all?
That is it. I've got lots to tell you.
That's fine. Bit of a challenge for me.